recall at one point when I was fibrillating and he treated me on the phone. I haven't had any atrial fibrillation since, and that's about 3 years ago. Very successful.
Since then, I've always called Dr. Callahan, and I have not been in the hospital since then. That was the last visit I've made to the hospital.
2.5 years ago, I had a heart attack, and I was dead for 8 minutes.
Hello, I'm Dr. Roger J. Callahan, founder of Thought Field Therapy. I graduated from the University of Michigan and obtained my doctorate in the clinical psychology program at Syracuse University. My doctoral research was on anxiety and phobias in 1953, and I've been specializing in these problems ever since. In my quest for more rapid and effective treatments, about 25 years ago, I discovered what I now call thought field therapy. I've been developing and improving it for decades. Stresses that were contributing to serious health issues like atrial fibrillation, physical pain, heart failure, and even AIDS. But before we hear from them, I would like to mention some of the research. A Harvard University research study by Kawachi and others tells us that phobias and anxiety may contribute to an earlier than normal death. The study concludes, phobic anxiety may contribute to an increased risk of sudden death. I believe it is important to eliminate the stress of phobias and anxiety for your improved longevity. Psychology has never had an objective, placebo-free instrument to measure stress and the degree of improvement. Now we have that measure. It's called Heart Rate Variability, or HRV. This measure can show the degree of improvement with stress reduction. HRV measures can often help warn us, letting us know we may need to see our physician before a serious health problem takes hold. In the famous Framingham study, HRV was shown to be the only test out of many that predicted sudden death in people who had shown no signs of a problem until it was too late. Irving Dardick, a vascular surgeon and founding chairman of the Olympic Sports Medicine Council, comments on HRV. It is an extraordinary fact that HRV stands alone as a single risk factor of virtually all chronic diseases and behavioral disorders at all ages. What I often find, and you will see during this show, is that when we effectively treat an individual's life stresses, we can often improve their overall health. And this improvement correlates with an improvement in their HRV scores. This holds true even with those facing serious or chronic health problems. The reduction or elimination of stress can decrease their risk of death and improve their health. A recent study by Bill Chick and others in the American Journal of Cardiology even quantifies the degree of improved health we can get when we improve the HRV. They state that each 10 milliseconds improvement in an HRV score translates into a 20% decrease in our risk of mortality. As an example, David's HRV score improved from an alarming 6 to a more normal 110, where it is currently. The textbook on HRV states, numerous studies have found low HRV to be a powerful predictor of all-cause mortality. I think we would all like to decrease our risk of death. Atrial fibrillation is not only stressful, it is frightening and can be life-threatening. Always consult your doctor about it. We learned from the Kawachi study that phobias and anxiety can contribute to an increased risk of sudden death. Research shows the negative effects of trauma on your health. Through my continuing search for ways to eliminate stress, I have found some simple self-help procedures that can reduce the stress of phobias, anxiety, and trauma. As you listen to Conrad and Joe talk about how they quickly helped others with these simple self-help procedures, I'm sure you will be able to relate to someone in your family who might benefit like they did. Research suggests you can increase your health by reducing the related stress of these problems. The research studies I have mentioned help us understand the importance of stress reduction. The Framingham and Bill Chick studies demonstrate the importance of HRV. An international task force of cardiology states that HRV may be useful in measuring the efficacy of therapeutic interventions. And now we have just seen some life-enhancing results from thought field therapy. You too may benefit from the reduction of life stresses and may improve the quality of your life.
I am so enthusiastic about thought field therapy, and the work and the discovery that Dr. Callahan has done and is doing that makes it possible for people to find relief from so much of the pain so many people are in, which is either not treated or mistreated or just neglected altogether. The fact that there is now a way to approach those kind of psychological problems and give people some relief from their pain and their problems is just miraculous to me, and I'm totally enthusiastic about it and can't stop telling everybody.
Thank you for watching. I'm Dr. Roger J. Callahan.
To learn more about thought field therapy and heart rate variability, call our office at 760-564-1008 and find out how you can work with Dr. Callahan to reduce your stress and improve your health. Call 760-564-1008 to receive free information and ask how you can get a free HRV scan, improve your quality of life, and reduce your stress.